SharePoint is what we're using as kind of the environment for Pi Web Parts. It's a portal technology, and sometimes you'll hear reference to Windows SharePoint services, sometimes Microsoft Office SharePoint Server. You can go look up the difference between the two. They're basically Microsoft technologies, different functionalities, essentially built on the same platform that's generically called SharePoint. And SharePoint is what we built Pi Web Parts on top of. So let's go over some of the fundamentals about using SharePoint. Here is a Pi Web Parts display. And on this Web Parts display, you'll notice, first of all, there's specific zones. Actually, let's go to a more generic website for SharePoint. Let's go to the basic SharePoint homepage that you'd normally see. Now, this is divided into specific zones. And those zones are where you would drop what are known as web parts. So if I go out to my labs site, this is the one I can actually work on. If I go into edit mode, you'll notice there's a left zone, a right zone, and different sites are going to have left, center, headers, footers, etc., different zones. Let's go to another site. Yeah, this is the one we were looking at earlier. If I edit this page, again, you can see the different zones. In this case, we have a left column, a header, top row, center column. These are just the different zones that we support. And here there's a center right column. So those different zones are one of the fundamentals of SharePoint. On those zones, we can add these web parts. Now, Pi Web Parts is just one type of web part that you can add on these zones. As you saw in some of those previous pages, Microsoft makes web parts. Different web parts to do different things, document libraries, lists, things like that. And we do Pi Web Parts for looking at real-time data. Now, these zones can be configured so that you can pass parameters among the different zones. So, for example, if I get out of edit mode here, you'll notice that what happens in one zone here can affect what's in another zone. So if I switch from unit 1 to unit 2, we're passing parameters over there through connections, these web part connections. So in general, it's a highly configurable environment. If you actually take a look at our RT Web Parts class, we'll go into some detail about how you can add even further configurations. We're not going to get into that kind of detail in this class. But we do have to start with some fundamentals, how to build a web part page, how to add web parts to that web part page. Those types of things. So that's what we're going to do very first thing we're going to do in this class, learn about some of those web parts, things like document libraries, so that we'll be ready to make use of these web parts on these web part pages.